Today we are in our seventh module of the genetic counseling course. The next talk will be about methods of finding disease that cause of method of finding gene that causing disease. طبعا, these methods are developing. يعني every now and then a new technology is coming out, a new softwares, a new thoughts. So things are really developing very fast. What I would like you to know is the basic, and then we'll move to the recent updates in. Same strategy. طبعا, by definition, it's a process by which a scientist means that a lab scientist, molecular scientist, and who provide diagnostic or research services even. The idea is the same. They all target the gene pathology that caused the phenotype presented, either requested from the clinician or by the clinician himself. So to identify the mutant genotypes responsible for an inherited genetic disorders, as I said earlier, the technologies are advancing dramatically, more rapid disease gene identification, and identify more complex mutations. So day after day, I remember we maybe 6 years or 7 years back, we were sequencing a group of genes, يعني ممكن توصل حتى 32 genes, in a block of homozygosity. That block of homozygosity, we are sure that the disease-causing gene is located in that block. So we used to sequence all those genes, and every gene different from the other. يعني every gene may be longer, may be shorter. So every gene we have to sequence from A to Z, from exon 1 till stop codon, and see how much time that will take. And now things are different. Now we have NGS, next generation sequencing, and that next generation sequencing is really faster, cheaper, and will get a dramatic result that will help a lot in diagnostic services. Okay, the knowing the disease causative genes simplify the diagnosis and provide insight into the functional characteristics of the mutation. Now, when we know the pathological mutation of the gene that caused this phenotype, معناته إن في relation between the gene will disease. Now, the absence of this gene will result in a disease. It means that this protein has an essential part to do in the development of the certain infection of that organ. يعني, for example, inherited blindness or any abnormalities that concern with the eye. Now, if we identify the gene that caused this mutation in this phenotype, inherited blindness, it means that this gene plays a very critical role in the development of the structure of the eye. I'm taking the eye as an example. This can be applied to any other organs, okay? So, a new identification of the gene, an identification of the causative gene and that protein عطانا different insights, يعني new insights of the mechanisms. يعني for example, so the same gene will cause different phenotype. يعني في gene will cause albinism, and the same time will cause what? Blindness. So there is a relation between what? Melanin production, صبغة الميلانين, and the development of the structure of the eye. It means that, يعني look, and this really coming up, and a lot of info are really being added to the database. So this gene or this protein has an essential function in the development of melanin, and melanin has an essential part in development of the eye structure. So I'm trying to simplify the things. So different insight of different mechanisms, we never knew that before. Identified the gene or the protein that causing this disease gave us a new insight into the pathology and the pathophysiology and the mechanism of the development of such disorder. Right. I'm sure you are very much familiar with this chart, and I hope that you have it in your booklet, and try to remember when we talk about genetic disorders, على طول, divisions, single gene abnormalities, chromosomal abnormalities, multifactorial, and acquired somatic mutations. طبعا, single gene, autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked dominant, X-linked recessive, كذلك mitochondria and genomic imprinting, okay? Chromosomal abnormalities, either numerical or structural, okay? More numbers, less numbers, or deletion or duplication. Acquired somatic abnormalities, very famous example, حقيقة هو الكانسر, okay? Right? I believe we'll go through this later when we come to certain specified slides. The word candidate in English means what? Candidate means what? مرشح, okay? Means, يعني, a group of people, some of them is distinguished, so that one is the candidate. But in certain groups, يعني, that person will have similarity in other persons. So 5 in 10 are candidates. In other groups, 10 in 10 are candidates. Okay? So the candidate gene is the gene that we think, or we, because of the previous laboratory test done, that we feel the candidate gene, the gene which of interest, the gene of which causing the pathology, the gene which caused the disease, we call the candidate gene. طبعا candidate gene ممكن يكون candidate genes, يعني group of genes, the candidate gene is within them. So what we, or what we used to do, and what the technology is advancingly you doing, is to approach that candidate gene and to identify it and prove that this is the gene that caused the pathology, okay? So the candidate gene, a major component of genetic variation of phenotype investigated, is caused by functional mutation of putative gene. Putative يعني هو المتميز أو الظاهر أو okay. Gene with known biological function directly or indirectly regulates the developmental process of the investigated phenotype. Sometimes, يعني for example, autozygosity mapping done or something, and a group of genes actually identified. These genes are found in this homozygous region or loss of heterozygous region. So which one to you think will be the causative gene? You think. Then we do something called bioinformatics work. We look for literatures, any presented papers or research done on these genes, and we know the phenotype. So we know the phenotype, yeah, external features. So we think that this gene has been found to correlated to certain pathology. That pathology is similar to this phenotype, okay? To at least one of the characteristic features of that disease, okay? So we feel that this gene could be the candidate gene. So bioinformatics search will help us to identify which candidate gene to start with, to sequence, okay? يعني for example, يكون معك 50 genes, okay? And you want to start with one. So you use bioinformatics, okay? Which is really a developing science by itself, or technology by itself, to identify which gene to start with sequencing first, right? So candidate gene approach equal to gene disease research. It's the same idea, same phenomena. Two approaches for genetic dissections of complex and quantitative traits. طبعا trait means what? Feature. Trait means what? A phenotype, okay? So either genome-wide scanning or candidate gene approach. Genome-wide scanning, yeah, you scan the whole thing, you know, genome-wide, the whole genome. Blind, yeah, the whole genome, something there. Okay? So, but this will be really of presupposition. It will be highly expensive, and it will be highly resources consuming. And it only locates the glancing chromosomal region of quantitative trait loci, QTLS, which embed a large number of candidate genes. As I said earlier, genome-wide scanning, مثل ما ذكرت الأوتوزايغوستي. Autozygosity will show me in affected individuals, especially in recessive disorders, يعني a similar block. There is a similar block, okay, homozygous, أي متشابه. Only found in affected individuals and not found in normal or carriers, okay? So that some similar يعني area shared by all affected individuals. It doesn't mean that definitely the gene causing the disease in this block, but it is something to start thinking of, okay? So this will locate certain, you know, areas, homozygosity area here, homozygosity here, in chromosome 1, in chromosome 2, in chromosome 5, and some, a lot of things. So it will take more time also to apply more bioinformatic research to be sure which is the يعني more effective region to find the gene in, okay? بينما candidate gene approach extremely powerful for studying the genetic architecture of any complex traits, it's more effective, more economical, and for direct gene discovery. Because you are looking for a specific gene or genes, يعني مش block where maybe 50 or 60 or even 100 genes are there. It's limited by its reliance on existing knowledge. There is something came up, يعني new softwares that used to help us. يعني I remember I used in my early days some software called Endeavor. When you identify the region, okay, region that contain, for example, 32 or 50 genes, you take these genes, okay, and paste them in that, in the software there is like a space to paste them. And then there is another space to write clinical features of that family you are working on. And then the software actually will do like a multi-analysis. Yeah, it will go, has an access to all literatures in NCBI, for example, okay? And we'll go through all literatures, and then we'll organize or prioritize your gene list, okay, in different colors. So it will give you that this is the most appropriate gene, and this is the one after, and this one after. And then at the end, the least associated gene that you may look for, which will help you in identify the pathological mutation or pathological gene, okay? Now, Endeavor has been replaced to different softwares. Yeah, things are going, developing very fast. There is something called digital candidate gene approach. It's a computer-facilitated candidate gene approach and a novel web resources-based candidate gene identification approach. It is available in the web, okay? It's available in the web. That will help a lot also. And a lot of softwares I'm going to show you a list of. Here, a list that summarizes all applicable softwares and online tools that will that work together in the digital candidate gene approach, okay? As I said earlier, I used to use Endeavor, which is 2006 something, which is old one actually now. But there are other things which deal with the SNPs or a SNPs identifier. Okay, where what we do actually, we in autozygosity mapping, we sometimes mix DNA of affected individual. We mix DNA, and we apply them for affymetrix array to identify homozygous regions. يعني المناطق المتشابهة with affected individuals. Okay? يكون plenty. Plenty. في مناطق كثيرة plenty متشابهة. مناطق كبيرة، مناطق صغيرة. Okay? فthese regions we feel because they are in shared by the affected individuals and not by other members of the family. Definitely there is something common in this. يعني I won't say definitely but I will say يعني most probably the gene is within one of these regions. And then we do something called genotyping. Genotyping is typing what? The markers of that gene with the possible area. And then we see, are they similar among all affected individuals? Are they similar? Does it show any the same homozygous batch? And also it will help us in refining the region. Refining يعني تحديد بأكثر دقة. يعني مثلا block of region in chromosome 5 here. Available in affected 1, affected 2, affected 3. When we do genotyping, this region might be refined. يعني مثلا كانت 50 genes بتصبح 30. بتصبح 20. Okay? So things to help me to minimize the work. طبعا I'm talking about things used to be done 7 years ago. Now things are really different. Now we have different NGS platforms, different NGS techniques that sort out things directly. But I need you to know about this.
Anybody can access to this website?
I don't think so. I mean, you need to register, you need to pay, yeah. طبعا, you remember mutations types? We talk about the point mutation substitution. You remember that? Okay. When we ask about types of mutation. So what does substitution mean? One base pair is replaced by another, okay? And insertion? Insertion? A new base pair? Base pairs, new base pairs? A, T, G, C? Okay? Yeah? Base pairs inserted, okay. Deletion? Deleted. Frame shift? Usually frame shift, what does it mean? Frame shift?
Early stop code.
Early stop code, due to frame shift. What is frame shift? يعني if you delete or add, what will happen to the shift, to the code? It will change, okay? So it will give me an early stop codon, okay? Right. Now finding disease-causing gene, if it is a new phenotype, first time we are facing with syndromic features, never reported, okay? Never reported. We don't know about it in literature, nothing like that. So we study the phenotypes, clinical features. Right? And then we take family and medical history in details. طبعا genetic degree. And then we do something called genetic mapping. Okay? Mapping, يعني where mapping region that will have the candidate gene, the causative gene, we map it. Which part of the genome? Map it. Mapping, من كلمة map. which part of the genome. So there are certain techniques to be used to map the possible or the suspected causative gene in that genome. Then we do homozygosity region identification. Homozygosity can be done through autozygosity or even CGH microarray. Okay? Homozygosity region among affected individuals. Then we identify list of genes, as I said. And then after those list of genes, we do bioinformatics research. Okay, bioinformatics using softwares, using even our own literature reviews. Literature review. Any article published that talk about similar phenotype or similar gene, okay? For example, عندي قائمة من genes, واحدة من هنا شوف, يعني عندي phenotype معين مثلا. So, list of genes, as I said, right? Then we do bioinformatics. So, for example, we go to a literature review that discuss specific phenotype, which is similar to one of the phenotypes I'm having. Or the gene, this gene, for example, has been shown to correlate with similar phenotype. Okay, then I will try to prioritize my list of genes. بعدين طبعا, I'll start doing sequencing. Okay? Now, as I said, things are different. NGS sorted out all this problem. Finding disease-causing gene when a phenotype is known. يعني, for example, let me say neurofibromatosis for known features, caffolate spots, checking of the retina, hematomas, everything is rare. Then possible diagnosis neurofibromatosis, direct sequencing of NF1. Okay? List of candidate genes through bioinformatics, a literature review, single gene direct sequencing, and as I said, NGS gene panel. Right? Now, mutation detection, two groups of tests. We are still talking about methods used to identify the gene that caused the disease. So, two groups of tests, molecular test or cytogenetic test. For cytogenetic, there is something called also molecular cytogenetics. What is the example of, what is the technique that undergone or listed under molecular cytogenetic? CGH microarray. Okay, CGH microarray is listed under molecular cytogenetics. Cytogenetics, anything to deal with chromosomes. Okay, right? So convection karyotyping, fluorescent in situ hybridization or FISH, and comparative genomic hybridization, right? Karyotyping is typing of the chromosomes to identify any major structural defect or major numerical defect, or structural deletion, duplication, translocation, okay? Numerical, طبعاً زيادة number or less number. الفيش هو, as it said, fluorescent مشع. In situ hybridization, in situ in location. Hybridization, باللغة العربية هو ترتيب بحكم التشابه, okay? Hybridization is a laboratory method or laboratory terminology, which means that organizing or due to similarities. Okay, there are probes. يعني, for example, the George syndrome. We know that the George syndrome is due to deletion in 22q, right? So probes are there, synthetic probes. Those probes are really attached to fluorescence module, and that fluorescent will show some spark. Okay, and in FISH analysis. So we mix this with the patient sample, right? With the patient chromosomes, and then we see it if our synthetic probe fluorescent, and the patient did not, then it is missing. It is deletion. Then it is the diagnosis. But if our fluorescent, the reference one our probe is fluorescing, and the patient also area fluorescing, then patient did not lose that part, so it is not deletion, so it is not the diagnosis. And يعني, I'm trying to make it simple, because FISH can be used to, the idea is the same actually. A probe, synthetic probe is there, and that synthetic probe will hybridize to show me whether the patient having that part or not. So if it's having that part, I can compare two fluorescents. If not, only my synthetic will fluorescent, patient will not. Clear? And طبعا comparative genomic hybridization, CGH microarray, it's like looking at chromosomes in glance or in comprehensive way. It will show me copy number variation. It will show me deletions, duplications, okay, and also loss of heterozygosity areas, right? Loss of heterozygosity areas means what? Means what? Finding of homozygosity areas. صح? Heterozygosity against homozygosity. Okay. Molecular diagnostic provide a way of assessment of the genetic makeup of the human molecular inside the gene itself, inside the genome. Cytogenetic inside what? Chromosomes. So combines laboratory medicine with molecular genetics method for known mutation and methods of unknown mutations. طبعا as I said earlier in previous talks, type of nucleic acid اللي هم DNA والRNA, kind of, depends on kind of specimen, number of mutation, and of course reliability of the method used. Okay, this all really has to be taken in consideration when commencing molecular techniques for mutation detection. Known mutations, PCR and its various types. Okay, PCR, because PCR by itself can help in identifying a mutation. PCR is what? Polymerase chain reaction. يعني making 100 or more than 100 copies of that part of the gene or the genome itself in order to be used, okay, in other techniques, right? DNA microarray, as I said earlier, is sequencing, is reading the gene sequence, okay, reading the base pairs line. There is also called something called MLPA. This is for large deletion, okay, and large duplication, MLPA. Multiplex ligation dependent probe amplification called MLPA, right? It's another technique also used. Kits already made. There are kits made for which can be used. يعني it's another technique, a separate technique to identify Schismet deletions, no. Okay? Major deletions. No, Sanger is sequencing. Sanger sequencing for single base, double base, يعني deletion or insertion or substitution. But this one is for major deletion, okay? That cannot be picked out by Sanger sequencing or even by by NGS. Unknown mutation, single-stranded conformation polymorphism. هذه طبعاً methods اللي نقول لكم عنها not anymore used حقيقة. لكن الفكرة إيش الفكرة؟ الفكرة إن هذا normal sequence the wild type. هنا في عندي something for this sequence the patient I feel something happened, something wrong happened. Either substitution, either deletion or insertion or, you know, something wrong. So I'm comparing the DNA of that normal wild type with the DNA of the patient. I'm doing methods in order to see how this will be different. So there are certain methods that depend on denaturing of DNA and then separation of DNA and then running on gel. بعدين يكون في بيكتشر اوكي تميز بين النورمال الوايت تايب تميز الكارير تميز الافكتد رايت سو از اي سيد DGE or heterodoublex or even restriction of fragment length polymorphism. I'll show you some examples of that. Restriction fragment length polymorphism, there are something called what we call restricted or digestive enzymes. Those enzymes يعني identified in E. coli bacteria, okay? The enzymes cut the DNA sequence in certain places. يعني it work only on certain sequence of base pairs. يعني for example, this enzyme will cut in G, A, T, C, 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 G. It will cut in C, 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 for, as an example. Now, I have 3 CC for the enzyme to cut. If one C deleted, then the enzyme will not cut. So I'm applying the enzyme on a wild type, it will cut. In the same time, I'm applying the same enzyme on the affected type where C is missing, it will not cut. So I'll be able to see the difference. Okay? When enzyme cut, it showed me 2 bands. احنا دائما DNA لما بعد ما نعمل PCR نبغى نتأكد ان DNA اللي عملناه ل PCR صحيح في حاجة اسمها جيل الالكتروفوريسيس. هذا الجيل الالكتروفوريسيس اوكي تبين لي الدي ان اي باند الجيم مالي 1000 كي بي مثلا 1000 كي بي سو ذيس دي ان اي باند ويل بي اتاش تو ذا 1000 كي بي لادر ناو ذيس جي اف ريستريكشن انزايم كت ذيس باند ام جون هاف تو باندز تو ديفرنت باندز اوكي سو نورمال ويل شو مي 1 باند الاب نورمال ويل شو مي 2 باندز اند سو اون You don't have to know all these details, but it's good to know the basics. What PCR doing? What enzyme is doing? Restriction enzyme, okay? One of the methods used. For example, as I said, the SSCB, as you can see here, this is from my PhD thesis. Can you see here this patient is a carrier, okay? And which is here. You see the 3-1 carrier, see? These are normal, okay? See how the carrier appear? فقط الDNA عملنا لنا denaturation ثم cooling يعني high temperature فانفصل الDNA مش احنا قلنا double stranded DNA في temperature عالي جدا عشان ينفصل فينفصل ثم عملنا cooling فيقرب اوكي بعدين على جل بعدين نصوره ف as you can see here this patient is a carrier look how he looks like seventh also a carrier اوكي look how he like هذا الكنترول هذا normal now as you can see In generation 2, number 9 is what? Affected. See how it looks like? And also number 10 is affected. Compare it to the normal. Just below. But this one is only showing the carrier, the heterozygous. Sorry. Here also, you will see 3-3 is a carrier, okay? See how يعني, lovely image is that? Separated. While IV3, affected looks like this control will be the same because we are talking about what here a dominant one you know not the recessive يعني only one is affected so separation will not make any difference unless you are a carrier okay another example of SSCB بالنسبه للسيكل سيل ديزيز see how it shows the carriers these two blue okay here T instead of A, the blue is the mutant one. See, the carrier is having it and having the normal also. Carrier is having the normal, اللي هم الA والT, عفوا الA وال يعني السيكونس الأولاني اللي هو الA, which is طبعا complementary T, وكذلك الكارير having the mutant. This, يعني هو like a gel. You denature DNA and then you cool it in ice and then you see, you leave it for 1 hour and see the image. So it will show like that. The carrier will be separated. Now the normal for homozygous, recessive, normal bands are here. Carrier will have the normal and the abnormal. Sickle cell disease will have the abnormal bands. Okay? Sorry. Right. This one is before Sanger sequencing, before the development. يعني ف, they used to put fluorescent different tags عشان to know sequence of A, T, C, G. وكان يقرأوا like, يعني يقرأوا like this. تخيلوا A, T, C, G, G, C, T, A, وك. الحين طبعا things are different. Restriction enzymes اللي خبرتكم عنها. This site, you see this site here? TNA? هذا ال DNA. شايفين DNA? Double strand, صح؟ فالإنزيم will work in here. Okay, الإنزيم, the sequence مال الإنزيم will work in here. Now, as you can see, the T changed to what? C. بالتالي, same enzymes will not be able to cut. Okay, so if you run this, normal will show you it's cutted. This one did not show any cut. No digestion means what? There is a change in the sequence. وبالتالي there is mutation. يعني هذه traditional methods كانوا يستخدموها سابقا. طبعا we use this method متى؟ We work on the family affected. We identify the gene that caused the mutation. We sequence the gene, but we sequence the gene of one individual, صح؟ Now I have another 4 affected and 3 carriers and كذا normal. There are certain methods that will help us to save the time and the cost. Not to sequence the gene in all members, no. We do this procedure. يعني خلاص احنا عرفنا مكان الميوتيشن نفسه. Then we'll do, for example, restriction digest for that sequence, providing the enzyme sequence is there or not. يعني methods to minimize the cost and save the time. Right. طبعا as I said, next generation sequencing whole genome. عندي أنواع من whole genome. ذكر المسميات هذه زين. Whole genome, whole exome, clinical exome, and there is something called RNA sequencing or transcriptome sequencing. طيب. Whole exome sequencing, whole genome عفوا sequencing, that will sequence the whole genome, coding والنون كودينج. تمام؟ يعني الار ان اي مع الدي ان اي، الانترونز مع الاكسونز، everything else. الهول اكسوم سيكونسينج ويل اونلي سيكونس ايش؟ الكودينج سيكونس. كلينيكال اكسوم سيكونسينج هذا نيو. كلينيكال اكسوم سيكونسينج النون ميوتيشن او نون جينز ذات كورليتد تو كلينيكال فينوتايب جمعوها كلها في بانل. This will help us يعني in identify the mutation of rare disorders. يعني sometimes this will be like a solution of less يعني how to say it, cost effective and also time saving. It will help a lot. Okay? For clinical exome only deal with known genes or known proteins that associated with clinical phenotypes. Okay? Instead of doing whole genome ولا whole exome. Because sometimes يعني في mutations حقيقة في بداية الإكسون يعني في الانترون سيكونس اللي قبل بداية الكودينج يعني في العشرين بيس بير قبل بداية الكودينج هذه قد يكون فيها يعني سبلايس ميوتيشن أو something. فكلينيكال إكسوم will cover that لكن whole exome will not cover that. Whole exome will only concentrate on the exome. Right? طبعا ترانسكريبتوم سيكونسينج هذا يتعلق بالام ار ان اي يعني شيء يتعلق بالبروتين بال يعني anything related to the mRNA فعملية الترانسكريبتوم قبل وترانسليشن داخل الخلية نفسها يعني بمعنى آخر وظيفة شو اسمه أو وظائف البروتين والإكسبريشن أوف بروتين. أوكي طبعا in certain diseases in certain disorders you need to assess protein expression of that particular protein. طيب إحنا مثل ما قلنا سابقا الكودينج سيكونس only around 1%. أوكي more than 95% of the exons are covered. More than 95% of the exons are covered by whole exome sequencing. Okay, the whole exome sequencing will give me a coverage of 95%. 85% of disease-causing mutation in Mendelian disorder are located in the coding region. So, يعني it is justified حتى لو سميت whole exome ما حد بيلومك يعني لأن 85% of mutation that cause Mendelian disorder located, but there are other disorders that do not follow Mendelian inheritance. Okay, so you need to use other methods. Sequencing of the complete coding genome of the exome uncover the mutation causing rare, mostly monogenic gene disorder and reveal predisposing variants in common disease and cancer. اللي هما الكارير ميوتيشن أو ما يسمى pre-symptomatic mutations. Okay. الانترون انترون نو في سم ديسوردرز سم ديزيزز از كوزد باي ذات اريا جست بيفور ذا اكسون ولذلك لما نعمل سيكونسينج ونعمل اناليسيس بين فورماتيك اناليسيس اوف سيكونسينج نحط في بالنا على الاقل 20 بيس بيرز بيفور ذا اكسون لان بيوند 20 رير لكن ستيل يس سم ديزيزز يس ذي دو هاف deletion or splice mutation in the intronic region. وهذا عشان كذي clinical exome sequencing غطي هذه مع الكودينج يعني selective. Genome will sequence everything. Exome will sequence only exomes. Clinical exome will sequence the exome and what is known other thing part from the exome that caused the disease known already. Okay, correlated clinically. Example, هذا الفوندر سندروم اللي انا يعني اشتغلت فيه. Okay, how to approach? عندك family عندهم certain phenotype. إيش الفينوتايب اللي عند الفاميلي دي؟ Known, عفوا new phenotype. زين not known before. Some will have foveal hyperplasia. يعني مكان في العين كذا اسمه الفوفيا مسؤول عن acuity of vision. عندهم hyperplasia. تمام؟ they will have optic nerve decussation defect. طبعا عن طريق الميثودز مع الكيازما وغيره كذا في الأوفثالمولوجي. فعندهم decussation defect. Decussation هو تعرف الأوبتيك نيرف النيرف يجي من هنا. ون هنا اوكي عشان الرؤيه في الصوره في النهايه في لوكسوبيت الريجن الصوره تنضبط اوكي فعندهم ديفكت عندهم انتيرير سيجمنت ديسجينيسيس اني مال فورميشن على الانتيرير بارت اوف ذا اي وما عندهم البينيزم هذه الفيتشرز اللي معايا لان معروف ان اللي عنده البينيزم اوكي اللي هو شو يسمونه بالعربي؟ ايوه يكون معاهم مشكله في العين. انت الحين عندك مشكله في العين خلقيه في العين لكن ما عندك البنزم هذا النيو في الثين. ففاميلي 1 عندي 1 2 3 4 5 افكتد. طبعا النكست ليكتشر ويل بي ريلي ريلي انترستينج. اوكي بيكون ريلي انترستينج اون هاو تو يوز بالديجري يعني هاو تو هيلب هاو تو ابروتش سوليوشن جاست باي لوكينج ات بالديجري. تمام فعندي افكتد انديفيديوال صح وعندي ريسيسيف ديسوردر مش كذا عندهم الفيتشرز هذه فاميلي. هذه الفاميلي عملنا لها ما يسمى بايش الهابلوتايب فور ماركرز اللي هو جينوتايبنج. لقدن جينوتايبنج هو جينوتايبنج تحديد موقع في الجينوم يكون فيه الريجنز المتشابه بين الافكتد. اوكي جينوتايبنج اني ميثودز اني ميثود يو كان يوز فور جينوتايبنج. طبعا ذيس ار كولد ماركرز. انا طبعا اعطيكم معلومات قد لا تحتاج بس طالما طرحت يعني زين الواحد يقولها. اوكي هذه ماركرز ماركرز لمواقع في الكروموسوم معروفه في مواقع معروفه كل ماركر يعني ممكن يكون يعني حدد الكروموسوم 16 في الشورت وكذا كذا رقمه يعني معروفه الماركرز مال كروموسوم 16 كذا ماركرز مال كروموسوم 21 كذا ماركرز سموها. الماركرز هو الاماكن اللي فيه احنا نسميها مايكروساتلايت ماركرز. المايكروساتلايت هي ريبيت يعني دائما في الجينوم في ريبيت سي 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 سي, سي. سي 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 ريبيتس معروفه هذه. اوكي ثم تي 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 فراغ تي 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 غيرهن تي تي ماركرز في الريجن دي في فور اكزامبل 121 تي 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 وهذه متى وجد غير وهين كروموسوم 16. اوكي في الريجن دي احنا نسميها ماركرز ساتلايت ماركرز. ماركرز يعني هم يساعدنا في تحديد موقع الكروموسوم نفسه. اوكي ما يتشابهن يعني هذا السيكونس متكرر بهذه العدد وهذه النسبة في هذا الموقع. فجبنا الافكتد انديفيديوز واشتغلنا عليهم عشان نعرف ايش التشابه بينهم. فطلع التشابه في كروموسوم 16 مثل ما انتم شايفين الريجن دي هذا افكتد صح وهذا افكتد وهذا افكتد وهذا افكتد وهذا افكتد. شايفين الريجن كلها بلوك هوموزاغوستي هني هوموزاغوستي هني هوموزاغوستي هني هوموزاغوستي بس واحد منهم مشارك لهم في ايش في الجزء هذا. اذا هذا خفض علي بدل ما كل هذه الريجن صارت ايش هذه الريجن. اذا هذه التارجت مالي واضح. فاميلي 1 فاميلي الثانيه عندهم تو افكتد برضه ريسيسيف نفس الفيتشرز. جينا عملنا الهابلوتايب مثل ما انتم شايفين كروموسوم 16 بعد نفس الشيء. اوكي افكتد هذا موستلي كارير واضح. فهذه الريجن وهذه الريجن ساعدتني بعد مقارنة بذاك الفاميلي لتخفيض او ريفاين اوف ذا ريجن واضح. تمام شايفين الريجنز. اوكي سو باي ايدنتيفاينج ذات بلوك في نمبر اوف جينز ار ذير وي دو سيكونسينج. ناو بالان جي اس ثينجز ار ريلي فاست اند ديفرنت لكن كويس انكم تعرفوا البيزكس. اوكي ثانك يو فيري ماتش.
I'm still interested.